A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem. When Allah is going to dress His creation and His servants with the majestic light, everything crooked becomes straight. Means it doesn't come jamali. Jamal, you feel everything is beatific, everything okay. Jalali, it straightens everything. So if we're doing things that are a little bit off and not what is at the best of what Allah is wanting from us, then things can be a little bit intense where you feel it becomes like you, things are straightening. Every type of difficulty is a rahmah from Allah. So if a mosquito bites you, it's not something random. You thought, why I got bitten? Allah took something of a difficulty away. So that's the understanding of majestic light. Majestic light, it comes and dresses you with something and it takes away a difficulty. So that Allah can make an exchange. This negative light that we carry, when Allah wants to send the haybah and majestic oceans of power, it will come and replace the negativity. And that can lead to a little bit of hardship, some types of difficulties. And alhamdulillah, that can be lessened by daily sadaqah, the awrads and the zikrs, all of that is on the Muhammadan way app. Do good deeds in this month, make lots of salawats on Sayyidina Muhammad and all these practices and all these teachings lessen all of the misunderstanding. That by doing these practices then we can begin to feel, you feel an immense heat in the zikr and in the salawats. That Allah is going to send a heated light upon the souls to begin to open on earth what needs to be opened for the arrival of Sayyidina Mahdi.
As-salamu alaykum. We hope you are enjoying the video insha'Allah. Just a request that you help us continue to make such amazing Islamic content insha'Allah. Share the video with your friends and loved ones, subscribe to the feeds and donate. Every bit helps. Jazakallah khair, and we will return to the program.
The ruqya, which is a healing on somebody by reciting. If you've been granted a permission to do healing, that's one thing, but you don't want to enter into the oceans of trying to heal people when we haven't healed ourselves and get an ijazah. Energy is something that bounces off. So if we just visualize to make everything simple for the audience, is if you have a positive feeling one day and somebody's got 10 negative feelings on them. As soon as you go to do healing on them and you're not trained, you basically took the 10 negative from them and went away with 10 negative feelings. They go away happy maybe and you know, feel light, they say, it's great, I don't know, you were, that was really nice, I spent time with you. But you go away with the negativity. Now if you've been trained by the shaykh or the shaykh himself, he's been trained on how to process the energy and he's been trained on what to do, what not to do, how to convey the fires, how not to sort of touch so that that energy is a direct conveyance upon his own energy. So there's many different trainings. Without doing that, many healers become sick. Because they're just playing out there in this new age world of trying to heal and then they become sick, they become filled with negative energies and this energies. If somebody has mental difficulties, the healer can often pick up all of the depression and the sadness. and they'll all of a sudden enter into an ocean of depression and they don't understand that this was theirs or this was the person that they were dealing with. It's very difficult and very dangerous at this time, especially with this sickness and this COVID and all these different things that humanity is trying to throw upon people. Dalail al-Khirat is the immense ocean, and Imam Jayzuli was not the one who authored it. So when we teach about Malakut, he was the one whom given the blessings of allowing it to come onto earth. Allah granted him the ni'mat of giving it through him to bring it onto earth. But this is Allah's ancient oceans of power. That ocean of power that is moving was we call the Muhammad. It's the ocean of Sayyidina Muhammad's power oceans that are moving, that obliterate everything and bring everything into the oneness of Allah. That power, when they enter into that ocean, they hear that like a humming. That's that power is Dalail al-Khirat, is being recited by purified souls of awliya, of sahabi, of angels. That's the ocean of Muhammadun Rasulullah in the ocean of power that obliterates, we call Muhammah. The Muhammah, it obliterates everything, mahi. It crush everything so that it enters pure into Allah's presence. So reciting daily, then imagine its immensity. One, you're mimicking the reality of the ocean of power, so then your soul is now sort of synchronizing with that ocean of power, that your immense love for Sayyidina Muhammad begin to grow because you're reciting something that can't be understood on this earth. You're reciting and reciting, your soul is now becoming energized. As a result of your soul becoming energized, you begin to fight off every type of badness. So why do you have bad desires? Why do you have affliction to all sorts of haram and all of these different things? It's because the desire is stronger than your ability for your soul to fight it. So in the formula of the energy, the negative is stronger on you than the positive. So how do you combat negative desires? Increase your positive. When your positive is so positively charged, it repels everything negative until you again let it come in by food, by drink, by people, all of the negativity comes and all of a sudden their desire, their energy comes into you and you go back to the bad habit. But Dalail al-Khirat has immense power to fight off all of those desires and difficulties and then make the soul to glow with the Muhammadan love, inshaAllah. It's like a beatific dish from paradise given by Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Why would you want to throw things from other dishes onto that? Then it become like a kalapache, become like a smorgasbord of you don't know what's in this pot. I mixed a little bit of this, I mixed a little bit of that. So all of those things we don't believe them to be to the caliber of what Sayyidina Muhammad is authorizing and opening. When you stay committed, is when you're loyal and committed and say, this is, I want the Muhammadan reality, I will struggle to reach the Muhammadan reality, then I don't throw any contaminants into that formula at all, because you're going to have to sanctify, you're going to have to purify, you're going to have to calibrate yourself to get permission from Sayyidina Muhammad. So that becomes something very pure. You wouldn't dare take into that pure thing and now throw somebody else's lesser understandings into that. Then you just contaminate the whole thing, and then Prophet is not pleased with you mixing things together.
As heavenly beings, we are on an eternal pursuit of angelic power. This book invites the seeker to attune to the guides of heavenly knowledge and discover the essential techniques we need to acquire to increase our positive energy within. In Pursuit of Angelic Power, available now on Amazon.com. Are you ever searching for what zikr to recite for a particular need? We bring to you the Muhammadan Way app, an all-encompassing Islamic guide, where you can find special du'as and prayers, as well as comprehensive Islamic teachings. Download this powerful app now on iOS and Android.
Before about depression and anxiety, and why depression and anxiety is so prevalent upon the earth, because the soul has a coordinates. It's getting an understanding every night, every moment it's in a Wi-Fi with Divinely Presence, every moment. So the greater soul that's always in Allah's presence, and the lesser consciousness that Allah gave as a drop into your physicality. He didn't give you the whole gift to go out and destroy it, He just gave you one drop of the light into your body. Your greater reality is continuously trying to talk to you, you know that we promised Allah this, you know we were supposed to do this, you know we're supposed to do this. Well, if somebody keep telling you all day long you're supposed to be doing something and you're not doing it, what are you going to become? Anxious? And then when you know you're not doing it, because this is deep from the soul, you're going to become depressed. Anxious that I know something's about to happen, I know I was supposed to do something, I'm supposed to be building myself, there's like a slaughter field coming and I'm not doing nothing. So of course you're going to be anxious and then depressed. And that's why then the zikr, the practices, the meditation, the salawats, all of these illuminate the soul, give it more power, give it more energy to push away negative. When you push away the negative, now you can begin to feel the inspiration within the heart coming. When inspiration comes, you feel like, oh, I did everything, I packed everything, I did everything I believe I was supposed to. And then that becomes your internal compass in life. Is that, you know, you have a responsibility, you can't just sit at home and say, I'm not going to do the responsibility. Of course you're going to get depressed, you're going to get nervous, and if they love you, you're going to have a lot of problems. You can't just sit and not do it, so you have to, you know, finish what you committed to. And that becomes then the stations of Rijalullah in their training. They understood, they have commitments, they have responsibilities, and they have to do those. And the commitments of the heavens far outweigh the commitment of dunya. It's not even any comparison. People try to make the love relationship amongst people, and because they don't understand the relationship with Allah and Sayyidina Muhammad, so I meet XYZ and I say, I'm going to put all my love in you, and you're going to put all your love in me, and I'm going to change you to be something that I want, and you're going to change me to be something you want, and none of that's going to happen. Because you don't change anyone on earth. Shaykhs can't change anyone, nobody changes anyone. Allah, you know, to guide one person like moving a mountain. You can move a mountain easier than to guide somebody and change them. So when unrealistic expectations among people, what they should have done in life is that I have to love Allah first. And my love is for the Divine, my love is for Sayyidina Muhammad, and I commit my heart to the love of Allah and His Rasul and my faith. When my love is correct and I calibrated my heart with that which is eternal and that which never lets me down, the love between me and you is in the jigar, right? My liver for you. So we have expressions, jigarit biram. And why do they teach those things? And they never use heart in the talk of love. They don't say, my qalb is for you, because this is a shirk with Allah. Their heart is for Allah. They say, sinam, my chest is for you. Well, that can be very broad, anything in my chest is for you, but my heart for Allah. So they were teaching on how they talk and how the grammar of what they would use. Everything now became the heart, oh my heart for you, your heart for me, and then you're putting the wrong love inside that heart, and Allah will make it then to be broken. To show you, nobody should be in there except me, everybody else will sell you. They sold Sayyidina Isa for a bag of coins. So at any point in your life, somebody will sell you, finish with you for less than a bag. So if you do what you do for people, you will become greatly disappointed. But if you do what you do for Allah, you don't care how many times they sell you, because you did it for Allah and Allah gave you the reward. So tariqah comes and teaches real love and a love that's eternal. Because whatever you give your heart to, you're going to be locked for eternity to that person, place or thing. And that's dangerous, to put your heart onto something that is not going to be of any benefit for you for eternity. But if you lock your heart onto that which is eternal and that which has immense blessings, then you should be successful here and hereafter, inshaAllah. Bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al-Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Shaykh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Shaykh Nurjan's teachings. Want One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide. From feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. NurMuhammad.com/donate.
Click the link now to subscribe.